In this video, we are going to look into how to prepare a 3D model for this stone, and furthermore, I would like to make it into a ring with the 3D printing and casting and set the stone for the whole process. Are you ready? Let's get started. First, let's find out the size for the stone. I want to measure the width, length, and the height. It is coming into 13.29 by 18.33 and 7.79 with the digital caliper. Let's go to the top view, and we are going to use the oval command and from the center. We're going to hit 0 to center it. The first number we're going to put it in there is 13.29 divided by 2, since we only use half of it. The second number we're going to put it here is 18.33 divided by 2, and then so that gives us the base for our curve. Let's go into the front view. We're going to use the line command right here and going up for 7.79. All right, so that is how high it is going to be. To creating this surface, I'm going to use the curve tool. Coming at the front view, I will like to snap into the endpoint and quadrant, starting from the endpoint and coming down roughly about here. We want to make sure that smart track is on, and we're going to come into the top and snapping into the quadrant. So this is the curve that we have over here. You can also use the other way to get a smoother line by putting a little tap here and also another tap here. So instead of draw the line, I will use the blend tool to blend from this point to this point. So that way you will get really smooth line over there. The command we're going to use next to creating the stone, it's called rail revolve. We're going to pick up the curve, and then we're going to pick up the rail and tell it the Rhino where's the axis. And that's how we get this one. Using the cap command will make this surface into the solid, and then this is will be our stone. It may not exactly the same with your stone on the profile, but it's for the rendering purpose. The key component is the curve that we have on the bottom. Coming to the front view, let's make a ring shank size. I'm going to make its diameter 16 millimeter and move my stone up roughly about here for the height. Definitely you need to consider the thickness on the bottom for the better casting. Now we have everything in the position. I do want to have this curve offset a little bit bigger. It really depends on the shrinkage of your wax and your casting. If you know that it's a certain shrinkage, you might want to go by the shrinkage. For the demonstration purpose, I'm just going to go 0.2 millimeter slightly bigger for the stone. So that way, when my model shrink a little bit, it will fit. Let me offset this guy. And this time, the offset will be the thickness. So I'm going to make it 1 millimeter, and that will be the thickness of my metal over here. And I'm going to rebuild this curve. Currently it has 50 points. It's because it's coming from offset. I'm going to change it to 12 of them. So I have the curve look like this. Let's make a copy first and pick up one of it. We want to pick up those control points, like every other control point. So holding your shift and click, and that's moving the gumball up so we have the basic shape over there. Let's go ahead to create the outer shape. We are going to use this command right here for the ellipsoid, and we are going to use the diameter. Let's click on the first quadrant, second quadrant, and the third one. And for the height, I wanted to go over a little bit, and so that will giving a nice taper looking. To actually to cut this, we are not able to trim it unless this curve is attached to the surface. So we're going to use the command called pull. We're gonna pull this curve back to this surface. Now you see the curve is hopping on this surface. With that curve is select, let's go ahead to trim the top off. That's how we get our first shell there. Due to the shrinkage, I would like to this surface follow that 0.2 guideline that I have there. So let's go ahead to offset this surface. Let's pick up this surface and we want to offset for 0.2 millimeter. We don't want it to be solid, just that surface right there. And we are going to pull it back one more time. This time pull this curve back to this surface. Okay. And you may notice that you have something like this is because we have a seam over there. It's really simple to solve. We just need to pull one more time. Because every time you pull, you can only pull into a single surface. So we are going to pull, and we're gonna pull from that to this surface. So now we have those two curves. Let's go ahead to join them and use them to trim off the surface over there. Okay. That's using the surface from Planar Curve. And let's pick up this curve and creating this surface right there. Let's join this one and this one together. Second things we need to do is we want to creating the surface over there. That's using the blend surface tool and make sure that the chain edge is yes. So we want to pick up this edges and pick up this edges. You can adjust the bump if you like to. And once we have everything, we just need to go ahead to join everything. Double check that if this is a solid. Right here on my property showing closed solid poly surface. Now we have done that, we need to creating the ring shank. I'm going to use the Conic Corners rectangle tool and snapping in the center to the quadrant. And let's take a look on the right view. And let's move it down so you get something look like squarely oval. That's using the move tool to move from the quadrant to the quadrant so it's not cutting inside of a ring shank. Second things I wanted to do is to mirror that to the top. I'm going to use the 3D scale from here to here and moving up a little bit, like whatever size that is suitable. We're going to the surface with the sweep one rail. This is gonna be the rail cross section and cross section. Make sure they all align, and I personally like them to be aligned in the inside of the ring shank. So that's moving to inside of the ring shank and make sure all the arrow is aligned to the same direction. It's gonna do only half of them. It's because we need to close the sweep on the option here. So that's how we get this one. We're going to have a Boolean split this one out of the shell that we pick. And that's did it everything inside. Now let's go ahead to Boolean unit together. Double check that it is still closed solid poly surface. Once we have done that, I do like it to look very nice and round on everywhere. So I'm gonna giving a little bit fillet. So let's go to the fillet edges command and let's do try one and see how this go. All right, look really nice. And we're gonna try that again. All right, so now I have this nice and round. We need to cut off anything. It shouldn't be inside of a ring shank. Go to the solid. Extrude a planar curve straight, and let's use the Boolean difference this out of this one. Sometimes your difference will fail. It's because all the seam is currently perfectly aligned right now. So what I like to do is actually I want to make them just slightly bigger, roughly about that. It's really hard to tell by the eye, but it does make the Boolean job much easier. Let's go into Boolean difference. This one will be out of this one. All right, so now we have everything ready. This is double check this is still closed polished surface, and we are ready to 3D print and cast this one. Don't forget to check the video on the Thursday. I'll show you my printing result, casting result, and how I set this stone. See you next.